What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Patrick here, moving on to another question. So the volume of a cylindrical can is 2 pi x cubed plus 17 pi x squared plus 40 pi x plus 16 pi centimeters cubed. The can is 2x plus 1 centimeters high. What is the radius? Now, this question is fairly tough. It's not going to be too difficult algebraically, but just manipulating equations is sort of different. It's unique dealing with these pi's here, as you can see in this polynomial. Usually we don't see that. So we're dealing with a cylindrical can. Notice we're given the volume, we're given the height. So what is the general formula for the volume of a cylindrical can? Well, we know it's pi r squared h. All right, so we're given the volume, pi is just a constant, we're given the height, and we have to solve for this r here. So this is the equation that we can use. So let's plug everything in to this equation that we are given. So the volume of the cylindrical can is that whole expression. So the left side is going to be that whole expression up there, 2 pi x cubed plus 17 pi x squared plus 40 pi x plus 16 pi. And we have this right side of pi r squared, which is what we're going to be solving for. We're solving for the radius, and then the height, it's given as 2x plus 1. Okay, so to get this radius here by itself, what we can do is we can divide this right side by pi, this expression, times 2x plus 1. This expression. What's going to happen is notice how the pi's will cancel out, the 2x plus 1's will cancel out. But what we do to one side, we have to do to the other to keep this equation valid. Okay, so now what we end up having after the next line would be all of this here on the left side is just equal to r squared, which is not bad. Question is how are we going to deal with this pi here that's involved? It's just a constant, so it's not a big deal at the end of the day, but it does make things a little bit more complex. So there are multiple things you can do. You can notice how this is division, right? You're dividing a polynomial up here by another polynomial expression down here. What you can do is you can take this pi, you can distribute it inside the bracket, and if you do that, you'll end up with 2 pi x plus pi, right? Where the pi is just a constant. So you can take this expression, divide it by this expression. However, that's going to be sort of weird. When you're dealing with those pi's, there's going to be a lot more chance, probability of you making a mistake. What I would suggest doing is manipulating this numerator first. Notice how this numerator, and another thing is this should be x cubed. Sorry, I keep making mistakes all the time in these last few questions that I did. So this should be 2 pi x cubed, right? That's the expression that we were given. Notice how in the numerator, there's a pi for each expression. So what you can do is you can factor out pi from this expression in the numerator, and you'd be left with 2x cubed plus 17x squared plus 40x plus 16. And then at the bottom, you'll still have pi and 2x plus 1. But now, notice now what can happen. The pi's can cancel out because you're just multiplying them up here and you're multiplying them down here. So those two terms can go away. And now notice that you are working with a way nicer division. You have this 2x cubed plus 17x squared plus 40x plus 16 divided by 2x plus 1. So we got rid of these pi's here. So this is how your next line would look like. And now this is just long division. You're taking a polynomial, dividing it by another one. Now, usually when we do manipulation like this and we're isolating for a variable, usually we're just going to have the variable by itself. Notice here how we have this r squared. So it's a little bit more complex still, but we'll deal with this r squared at the end. Let's just work on simplifying this left side here, taking this polynomial function in the numerator and dividing it by this one. And since this is a linear polynomial function, you can use synthetic or long division. So I'm going to do long division to simplify that left side. So taking this polynomial, dividing it by this one. So how many times does 2x go into 2x cubed? X squared times. So x squared times 2x gives us 2x cubed. X squared times 1 gives us x squared. Subtract both of these. 2x cubes cancel out. 17x squared minus 1x squared gives us 16x squared. Let's bring this 40x down. So we are adding it. 2x goes into 16x squared 8x times. So multiplying everything out, 8x times 1 gives us 8x. When we are subtracting here, 40x minus 8x gives us 32x. Plus 16, how many times does 2x go into 32x? 16 times. So multiplying everything out, 16 times 2x gives us 32x. 16 times 1 gives us 16. And these net out to 0. So remainder of 0, which makes sense because in our original expression, when we had the r squared equals the polynomial, the division of the polynomials, there was no remainder remaining. So I don't have it written down here, but we had r squared equals these two polynomials. So this polynomial in the numerator, this polynomial in the denominator, and those two dividing simplify to this here, this quotient. So our next line would be r squared equals x squared plus 8x plus 16. However, we don't want r squared. We just want the radius. We just want r by itself. So usually when we have an r squared, what we're doing is we're square rooting both sides. However, in this case, what I would do is I would just factor that right side. And when we factor that right side, notice how that's a perfect square trinomial. So that would factor into x plus 4 squared. So now we have r squared equals x plus 4 squared. So this r is like in brackets. So notice how these twos can cancel out, and basically r then has to equal x plus 4. So that is your final answer. The radius is x plus 4 centimeters. And if you really want to check your answer, you can go back to our volume formula for a cylinder, plug everything in. So we got pi. Our r is x plus 4, and that's going to be squared, right? And then the h is 2x plus 1. What you can do is you can expand all of this and make sure that you get that same volume, which you should get. So that is our answer. The radius is x plus 4 centimeters.